Right, another day, another load of squats to do. As I mentioned on the previous video, guys, so do frequency training, especially at maximum weights or your maximum lifts, or 90%, 95% or more, can become quite taxing on the central nervous system. Today I feel a bit sluggish, but I'm gonna man the fuck up and crack on. So Tuesdays, we have pause squats. So obviously we're gonna start with that. A back squat. What I'm gonna work on today, if you've seen yesterday's video, I'm gonna work on pausing at almost a 3/4 of the way back up. Solid depth, pause for about 4 or 5 seconds at the 3/4 mark, back up and back down. So it's gonna be 5 second pause at sticking point. So the point you find where you need to put the most effort in, or where you almost stop stationary, is known as the sticking point. And it is a good idea to look at that area and work on that area specifically if you want to do or to increase your squat overall. So 5 second pauses at the sticking point times 3. We'll be doing 5 sets of that. B's, we're then going to go into some RDLs. RDL 5x5, no messing around, basic, nice and simple. Hit the hamstrings and some more lower back work. We're then going to go to body weight hamstring work, which I show you. We're going to do C1 superset, C2, single leg Swiss curls times 10, and single leg glute bridge times 10. And then to finish off, we're going to do some shoulders today. Deep shoulders, which will be a giant set, hitting all heads, probably 3 sets times 3. So that's today's plan, guys. Starting with back squats, do a few warm-up sets, get a decent amount of weight on the bar, pausing 4 to 5 seconds at my sticking point, moving into RDLs, 5x5, quite light today. C1, C2s, we're gonna isolate the hamstrings, single leg work, Swiss curl and glute bridges, and then you're gonna blast those shoulders to finish. Let's have a look, shall we? Legs are feeling heavy as fuck today, so we're gonna take our time warming up, a little bit longer on the warm up. I'll show you with the empty bar what I mean by today's version of the pause squats, where we are literally stopping still at the sticking point. So we will in depth, back up. Pause at the sticking point. 4, 3, 2, 1, drive through. So that's how the squats are gonna go today. We'll do our 5 sets of 3 on that, and then we will work up to a 1 max rep for today as well. But I'm gonna warm the fuck up because my legs are feeling a little bit poorly. Last of the warm-up sets, I'm going on the bar, 3 reps, 4 to 5 second pause at the sticking point. Again, like I've mentioned, so the main reason behind this, guys, is to get our body used to working through that sticking point. So just put it on the brakes, as it does with your 1 max when you're squatting. Put it on the brakes fully, and then being able to put that pressure or that output back through from that sticking point. You want to keep the weights way lower than your normal working set as well, so that pause will take out here. So we're going to blast this set, first working set out. One, And that sticking point, building the muscle, and it's more of a psychological sort of build up as well, getting used to being in that position and pushing through. I'm going to do another two sets. I won't record it to save time. Next up now is into three singles. Okay, first single, 140, it's blasting. Nice one, 40, a done. Fuck me, it's getting hot today. Right, we're gonna blast it at 160. One more set, we're gonna go up to 180, ass to grass, squats done for today. Right, it's too hot to wear clothes today, so I don't give a fuck, I got my tits out. Legs are feeling really heavy now today, so I'm gonna belt up 180, hopefully it goes up. Last of the squats. You gotta like it. Yeah, that was a grind. A bit sluggish, but it's okay. We done it. We didn't die. Okay, moving on. So like I mentioned yesterday, guys, one of the cons of frequency training or training every day is you will become sluggish at some point, like I feel today. So that 180 was a fucking grind. But consistently hitting 180 every day for fucking what, about 2 weeks now. So the strength does increase. Again, you just got to pick what you want, whether you want to struggle and get strong as fuck, or whether you don't want to be strong as fuck, I guess, but, well, get strong, but in a longer time frame. I'm going to strip the bar down. We're going to crack out just the three sets of RDLs, nice and light. Again, I'm feeling tired, so we're just going to back off slightly. So three sets of RDLs, nothing major on the bar. And then we're going to blast out some single leg work. So we're just going to keep 60 on the bar. We're going to do three sets of five. Finish off legs. Okay, steady there. Next, I'm gonna put my toes on two little plates to show you. If you don't feel that, quite hitting the hamstrings, do as I do in the next set. Toes slightly elevated, but help you push your hips back and activate the hamstrings a bit better. Okay, so you can see the two little plates, guys. I'm gonna put my toes on them just to show you what it looks like. Again, five reps. So my toes are on the plates, and then again, it's the same, push the hips back as far as you can. Okay, one more set, I'll crack that. We'll come back to the video when we're doing our single leg work. Okay, the single leg work, 10 Swiss curls, in the 10 glute bridges, same leg, switch to the other leg. I'll just show you the one side the same time again, so you get the idea of what it is. five legs each leg. That's what it looks like. I'm gonna crack up the three sets, guys. Then we're gonna finish off with our shoulders. Fucking boiling. Right, the last little bit to show you guys to the end of the session. Shoulders. Three exercises back to back. I'll do five of each chest to show you. It's a dead stop front, guys. Make sure the weight stops when it's the bench. Make yourself dead on your next one. I'll do five of each. Enjoy, that'll be the end of the session. Today's session complete. I'll see you all tomorrow.